Hi, my name's Jason Morrell from Two River Software Training, and today I want to show you two methods for transposing data. Now, Joanne has asked, how do I transpose vertical data to horizontal and vice versa? So let me quickly show you a couple of techniques. So here on Excel, I've got a variety of data. Here I've got one column of data, here I've got one row of data, and here I've got a multi-dimensional set of data, so like a table of data. Now, the first method I'm going to show you is the paste special. So if you copy this range here, I've just used Control C there. You can use any method you like to copy. And I'm going to come across here to the starting cell where I want my new data transposed. I'm going to right click the cell and choose Paste Special here. Now, there's a whole stack of options you can choose from, but you can choose any of the stuff at the top there. But the important bit is the transpose tick box down the bottom. Now, you've got to bear in mind that if you leave this as all, then it takes everything, every element from the original set of data, which is not only the content, but also any formatting, any validation, anything else that's attached to the cell will come across as well. And the whole point of Paste Special is that you can then take off any one of those layers and just paste that bit. Anyway, back to the bit in question, the transpose, make sure that's ticked, click OK. Now, for the second one, it works exactly the same the other way. So if I select this horizontal range, I'm going to copy that. Let's come over here, right click and paste special, choose the transpose and click OK. Now for this third set, it works in two dimensions as well. So I select the range first, I copy, let's come across here, right click the starting cell, paste special, transpose and OK. Paste special works on one column, one row, or column and row as in a table of data. And you can transpose very easily using that method. The second method is to use what's called an array formula. Now, arrays are kind of getting into advanced territory here, but the way it works is like this. If you have a table like this, which has four columns and five rows, obviously when you transpose it, it's going to have five columns and four rows. So that's the bit you need to select first. Just go to a blank section and pick the range, the size you need it when it's being transposed. So in this case, 5 by 4. You then use a transpose function. So equals transpose, open your brackets, select the original range, and close your brackets. And that's it as far as the function goes. But what makes it an array formula is when you press Control Shift Enter. Okay, now transpose can only be used in the context of an array. It can't be used as a regular formula. If you have a look at the formula at the top here, it's got the function we put in there, but it's enclosed it with these curly braces. And that's what indicates that it's an array formula. But there you go, two quick methods. The first is to use Paste Special and tick the transpose box. The second is to use the transpose function, but that's an array function. You need to remember that. So I hope that helps. Thanks for sending your question in, and hopefully this can help somebody else as well.